So we're back in docs.docker.com/get-started, and we're going to get started with part two. Part two is creating a sample application. And what we're basically going to do in this part is to dockerize an application. So what is dockerizing an application? It basically means that we're going to create an image that's based on this application. Once we have this image, we can always create a new container that's based on this image. And of course, this container will run this application from within the container. This way, we ensure that the application will always run in the same environment for every physical computer that's actually running it. So let's get started. So this tutorial is based on a Node.js application, but if you're not that familiar with Node.js, don't worry, it doesn't really matter. The focus is really not on Node.js, but on Docker itself. So this application is basically a to-do list manager. And the first thing that we need to do is get the app, and we can do it from here. Download it as a zip file. And here it is being downloaded, and it was downloaded. It's not that big of a file. And let's extract this file. And when we get into this new folder, we can see all kinds of files and folders, and among them, we have the app folder. So what I'm going to do is open this app folder in Visual Studio Code. So let's get back to Visual Studio Code. And let's open the app folder. And we have here two subfolders, spec and source, and we also have the package.json file. So what we're going to do now is create a Docker file in the app folder. And we can see that Visual Studio Code changed the icon of this file to the Docker's icon. So that's what we want. Let's hit enter. And let's now copy and paste the contents for this file. So let's quickly skim through this file. So first we declare which is our base image. We never start from scratch when creating new Docker images. We almost always start from an image that's at least somewhat close to what we want to get to and build on top of it. So in our case, we want to get started from the node image with a 12.alpine tag. So 12 in this case is the version of node that this image uses. And Alpine is the Linux distro that it uses. The useful thing about the Alpine Linux distro is that it's a minimal distro. So images that are based on it tend to be smaller than the alternatives. So in our case, we want to get started from the node image version 12 that's based on Alpine Linux. The next thing we want to do is to install Python 2, G++, and make. Now notice the beginning of this command, apk add. That's how we use the package manager in Alpine Linux. So if, for example, we would use Ubuntu, we would probably go with apt install. But since we're not using Ubuntu, but Alpine, what we need to do is use apk add. Now the packages themselves, the ones we want to install, are Python 2, G++, and make, and this line is basically going to install them for us. We then define the working directory within the container. In our case, we define it as the app directory, so this is going to be the working directory within the container. We then copy all of the files from the working directory in our local computer to the working directory within the container. So the working directory in our local computer is considered as the one that contains the Docker file. So in our case, it's this folder, and everything within this folder will be copied, apart from the Dockerfile itself. The working directory in the container is the one we defined over here, so it's the app folder. We then use yarn to install all of the dependencies to our application, and then we run the cmd command. This is the command that's going to be ran once the container is up. So the command itself is node, and its parameter is this specific file. Now notice that we used in our Dockerfile both run and command. So let's talk about the difference between them for a second. The result of the run command is baked into the image itself. So the image that we'll get will contain the results for each of the run commands. The cmd command, on the other hand, will not be part of the image itself, but will be run on the container itself once it's created from the image. So it's a subtle difference, but all we have to understand is that one will affect the image itself, the image that we're creating, and the other one will only be ran on specific containers once they are created from the image and ran. The last command exposes port 3000 on the container, so that later we can use port forwarding to forward some specific port on our host to this port on the container. So let's save our file and move on. Let's now run docker build to create an image that's based on this docker file. So let's copy this command. And let's open the built-in terminal in Visual Studio Code. Now notice the dash T flag. It stands for tag. So getting started is going to be the name of the image that we're about to create. And the dot at the end tells Docker to look for the Docker file in the folder we're in right now. And the base image is being pulled from Docker Hub. And all of the following steps are being ran as well. Once everything is done, we'll have our new image. Now, Docker images are built in layers, and that's why we see this many steps. Everything is cached, so if in the future we'll create a new image that's somewhat similar to an image we created before, it will be much faster, because we'll already have the common layers. Okay, so our image was built, and let's take a look at our Docker tab. And we can now see that we have two new images, getting started and node. Node is the image we based on, so that's why we have it. And if we open it, we can see that we have the 12 Alpine tag. That's the specific image we used. The getting started image is the one we created ourselves according to our Docker file. Let's now create and run a container that's based on our new image. So of course we can right click on the new image and choose run, but I'm not going to do it. We're going to do it from the command line. And here's what we need to run. So docker run and then dash d. And dash d tells the container to run as detached, which means in the background. We then have dash p, and if we have multiple flags, we can clump them together, and that's why we get dash dp. Anyway, the dash p flag is for port forwarding. And as we can see, we forward port 3000 in our host to port 3000 within our container. We then need to specify the image, and of course it's going to be getting started, which is the image we just created. And the container was created and ran, and is now running in the background. If we open the Docker tab again, we can see that we now have this container that's based on the getting started image. Now, since we forward port 3000 to our container, we should be able to access this port from our host. And to do that, I'm going to access this address, localhost at port 3000. And we can see that the container responded and we get the application running in our browser. Let's try to add an item. And here we have it in our list.